price for my heart. And I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I've gone to the Father, fall in the grave.
Good morning. How's everybody doing? Everybody's all right? Yeah, I heard you. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice in it. Today we celebrate life, we celebrate spirit, we celebrate the Almighty God that gives us that opportunity to share and love. And our world today, right, really stinks. Things are going on. Really, like, not so. I don't know about you, but sometimes I get a little like, what is going on? And that's what we're all going through collectively. Amen? And everybody's got a story. Everybody's got their own individual COVID going on. Everybody's got their own twin towers that have fallen. Everybody goes through different things, and sometimes, you know, it could be little things that when we look at it, we go, oh, you'll get over it. Sometimes it's really major things. So today we want to celebrate. So we're going to celebrate in a lot of different ways. The first way we need is to call upon the living God and say, you know what? We need you to be present to us today, which He always is. So Lord God, we ask you to open our eyes so that we can see you. So that we can see you in the little things. So that we can see you even in the midst of a storm. Psalm 46:10 says, be still and know that I'm God. Psalm 46:1 starts and says, you are my refuge. You are my shield. Do Do we really believe that? I pray that today we be able to open our hearts and say, you know what, Lord? Yeah, we believe it, and we're joyful for it. So if there's anybody that has any prayers that would like to be mentioned today, please just shout it out. We pray for Kathy, who just came out of the hospital yesterday. She's doing well. That's super terrific. We pray for Phyllis, who is at home, and I hope that she's watching us today. We pray for Ed, who also is at home. We pray in thanksgiving for all the wonderful things. We see Tyrone and his wife back, and we are so grateful that they are in better health. So Lord God, we thank you for all the wonderful things you have given us. With that being said, every month we give out something called a white rose, and that goes to a person that has given their time and their energy and their willingness to do for our church. And this month, as we continue our outreach program, somebody stepped up and said, you know, I can handle it. As a matter of fact, this person even said that, look, I have a job offer on the weekends. I'm not going to take it because I think this is the most important thing. And so she came in. She does her work. Plus, she does the outreach. We're serving, the last count was 145 families. And we're going to keep on growing, and we're going to do what we've got to do. And that's in thanksgiving to our congregants, of course, and those of you that come to church every Sunday. But you all know that Lenny does her thing. The person, the contact person from here is Christina. So we'd like to give the white rose this month to Christina. Can you give her a nice round of applause? So the pink rose is for somebody, and I have my notes here because I wanted to have real criteria for it. And it will be given by our outreach community when they meet on Saturdays or Wednesday when we all get together. And it's about not counting the days, but making each day count. And there's somebody in this room that no matter what I ask this person to do, this person takes care of what needs to be done. He's been doing this, doesn't charge anything, whatever. Well, he better not, because he's part of my family. But he's constantly, constantly giving. Talk about an inspiration. How in the world did God bless me with a son like this? Just whenever, he's just willing. And so the pink rose for the month of October goes to my little boy, Joseph. And our final dedication will be done as soon as our service begins and as soon as the spring. That dedication is here. So with that being said, let's begin our celebration. Let's all please rise. as we sing our first hymn, Christ Be Our Light. It'll be up on the screen. Said, let's welcome each other. Let's wave. Hello, how are you doing? Okay, so and together let us pray our invocation, which will be up on the screen. Almighty God, as we stand in awe of your goodness and mercy today, we invite you to be present amongst us by the power of your Holy Spirit. Father, we declare that we love you. Thank you that you have made a way of love known through your Son, Jesus Christ. We pray that you would reveal this great love to us all today as we gather to worship. Lead us by your Spirit to praise you. May our hearts overflow with thanksgiving and our mouths proclaim your everlasting greatness. In his wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. Please be seated. Just popped in. Hi, Matt. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Hi, Dan. How are you?
Good.
Didn't you read my text? Don't be late. No, I'm sorry. I'm playing. Once a year, as long as this church is in its foundation, I'd like to be able to initiate a new award that we're going to do in dedication to Mandy. No matter where I go, where I'm at, whatever I do, pastoring here or pastoring somewhere else, I will take this award with me and we will continue to give this award out. The Mandy Award is going to be one that shows or is a person that always has a sense of kindness. Because that's what Mandy was about. You told me that Mandy was a sassy little girl. That she would get her way by who? But the joy that she gave to you and her family, and the joy that she gives to all of us. I mean, here we are in Bayshore, right? I mean, the outstretched arms of Mandy have reached so many different places. This award is going to be an award given to a person that shows that kindness, that believes in giving is important, that has an attitude sometimes of like, I can overcome this. I want to give the award to somebody, as Mandy would put a band-aid on things to make things better, of a person that has courage in the midst of trial, that can withstand the hurts, a person that has honor, a person that even in the dark times can show light, a person that struggles but then yet maintains. That's the spirit of man. That simple act of kindness to keep things moving in a storm. And so the outreach committee met, and we all, I mean, it was like I didn't even have to say anything, right? And then I met with Mrs. Cook for 2 minutes, and she had the same person on her mind. And so the first annual Mandy Award, which I'd like you to come up here, Mrs. Cook, and just let's show what it looks like. Or Mr. and Mrs. Cook, that would be okay. We'll take you both. Can you open the box so that we can see it? It's a heart. And it's the man you. And the first person that is going to receive this award is a person that's been through the struggle. The criteria for this would be a young person, a person that has had trials and tribulations, but yet shows incredible kindness. This person, this young man, went through a major tragedy in his life last year while playing around in the pool. I'm sure this person is always giddy and having fun. Something happened when he lost some of his fingers on his hand. And this person went through a dark time, amen, and is beginning to rise up. He is now producing albums. I love your music. It is awesome. What do they call you? Six Kid or something like that? Major Kid or something like that. But as Mandy was an inspiration and still is an inspiration to all of us, Danny Lepore, you are an inspiration to our community here. Please come on up and receive the first annual. Praise and worship of our Lord as He is in all of us. Amen. We can be inspired by each other to come before the Lord. Our anthem this morning is called Remember. I'm so good at this job, amen. Remember. Please let's everybody be in a feeling of prayer. Let's lift up our voices and our hearts as we begin our service.
Broken for all my sin.
Together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven,
first reading is from the book of Genesis, chapter 2, verses 18 through 23. The Lord God said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make him a helper as his partner." So out of the ground, the Lord God formed every animal of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to the man to see what he would call them. And whatever the man called every living creature, that was its name. The man gives names to all the cattle and to the birds of the air and to every animal of the field. But for the man, there was not found a helper as his partner. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall upon the man, and he slept. Then he took one of his ribs and closed it up in its place with flesh. And the rib that the Lord God had taken from the man, he made into a woman and brought her to the man. Then the man said, "This at last is the bone of my bones and the flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of a man this one was taken." These words of truth and may be heard.
Did you all hear that story? Now, last sermon last week, for those of you that were here, we were talking about God's desire. And God's desire to have a relationship with us. But when he made Adam in his image, that desire goes into Adam. And Adam needs a relationship. So, you know, as Linda read, God said, "Well, go pick an animal, like, go name them and stuff." So he goes around, "That's a lion, that's a monkey, that's a pig, blah, blah, blah. And he couldn't find anybody that would fill that desire. You see, God desires relationship with us the same way we desire relationship with one another. With that being said, let us sing together the hymn of praise, "Eagle's Wings." Together, our psalm recitation is Psalm 8. It'll be up on the screens. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You whose glory is chanted above the heavens out of the mouths of infant children. You have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foes and enemies. Together. yet you have made them. Bless the vine. With glory and honor, you crown them. You have made them rule over the works of your hand. You have put all things under their feet. Disciples spoke sternly to them, basically saying, get out of here. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, let the little children come unto me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these the kingdom of God belongs. Truly I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it. And he took them in his arms, laid his hands on them, and bless them. This is the gospel of the Lord. Its words are true and can be trusted. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. It's in the little things, it's in the little things that make a difference. Throughout the scriptures, Jesus uses little things to make an example. For instance, in Matthew 13, 32, what does he say? It's the seed, the mustard seed. If you have the faith the size of mustard seed, you can say to that mountain, move, and it shall move. In John 6 and 9, a little boy with 5 loaves and 2 little fishes. I mean, compared to what everybody else needed, it was the little things that made the miracle happen. And sometimes when we're going through a storm, sometimes when we're going through a hard time, sometimes when we're not feeling it, we tend to negate the little things. The little things that God is saying, I'm here, I'm with you, I'm part of everything. It's the little things. So I'm going to ask a couple of volunteers to come forward here as I go down. Okay. So I need to illustrate that it's the little things that make a difference. So I'm going to ask Hope to come on up here. Here comes Hope. And I'm going to ask Ben. I need you over here. Okay, would you go behind that table? And you go behind that table. As you can see, there is a hat. It's a chef's hat. Can you please put the chef's hat on? I hope it fits. Try it. Yeah, okay. That was good. That was really good. Okay. Underneath the table, you should have a bag. Right? I need you to take the bag and take out all the stuff that you have in the bag. Bring the bag up to the top table here. What I want you to do is put each ingredient on one of the napkins that you sit. Oh. Gil, could you do me a favor? Could you run to the kitchen? I need 2 bowls. I forgot to bring them out. How many of you know that it's many, many ingredients that make up your life? Amen? Some ingredients are good. Some ingredients are not so good. Some ingredients are necessary. Some ingredients are not so necessary. How many of you know that the Lord will allow you to go through things in your life that will bring you to your final place of where you're supposed to be, your destiny, amen? So that includes icky stuff. For instance, if I'd ask you to eat the flour, if you'd open this up and eat the flour, I don't want you to eat it, just open it up for me. Can you open up your flour too? You can make a mess because I have somebody vacuuming. All right? Doing good. Let's see, we got the flour. Wow. Oh. Thank God for you. So we got the flour open. Now, if I ask you, is the flour a brownie? You'd probably say, oh, we needed bigger bowls, but that's okay. Because we're actually going to make it.
He doesn't
cook. Oh, he does. Okay, we got that there. Okay. Okay, the illustration was going to be is they were going to put all this flour in a big bowl. Yeah, so that would be a big bowl. And yeah. Yes, you can do this. How many of you know? Now, we have two eggs here. Can you crack those two eggs and put them in there? Can you crack the two eggs? Now, eggs are an ingredient that binds the cake together. Did you know that? If you make meatballs, you put eggs in it, it binds it together. And sometimes it's really difficult to do. How are we doing over here? You did good. Super, we're doing a great job. Here, use one of the napkins. There's going to be times in our lives that we need something to bind us together. And that can be a cause, maybe a tragedy, maybe a hurt, maybe something like winning a soccer game. Ironic. Whatever that is, it brings everybody together. That's the A. But as we see here, we got a bowl. Oh, thank you so much. You're good. Okay, let's put some flour in there because we gotta make these brownies. Well, I don't know, you tell me. I don't know. I don't know. See, we are in control of the ingredients. Hear me. We are in control of the ingredients that God has given us each and every day. Okay, so you put the whole thing. So you decided that you want to make a lot of brownies. Yes, okay. How much did you put in? You put in all of it too. I want you to hear this lesson. Everybody listen. You are in control of how much you use and how much you don't. The Lord will bless you. But you know, you can limit the Lord by not really believing in the faithfulness of God. That God will be faithful even in the hard times, even in the rough times, even in the tough times. Who am I talking to here? That feels like, oh, you overflowed me with this tragic Lord. What am I supposed to do? And he says, my son died. You have what it takes to make it through. Paul says, you will never be given a trial if you cannot handle it. Paul says, but I do so many things that are incorrect, that are not right. Sin is just overflowing. We feel like that in our country today. Tragedy is overflowing. You know what Jesus says? My grace is sufficient. So we need to count on that. So, okay, now we got to add the eggs, right? To put it all together. Put that in there. Okay, so he does it nice and slow. How are we doing? Start to mix it there. What else should we put in our brownies here? What do you think, Ben? You've got some chocolate here. That's nice. Sugar. Sugar. Can you get your sugar out, please? No. There's no sugar. Stop the music. There's no sugar? Are you serious? Do you know what your brownie will taste like without sugar? I'm going to show you because I just happen to have made them. Well, not me. Dee Dee Kristen made them. These are brownies that this, all these ingredients were made. This is without sugar. Mm-hmm. really trying to bring you much. All right, I'll do it.
Jesus said, they will know you by the way you love each other.
So I challenge each of you this week to love a little bit more. And when you can't love, let's say you feel like, you know what, I can't do this. I don't have it in me. I don't got it. You don't have to have it. The Lord will speak through you. The Lord will love through you. So when the students are getting ornery and crazy and nutsy and your bosses are getting nuts and they want to plow over here and do this over there, and you're feeling like you just can't keep it going, take a rest. Remember grace. And continue on. You are a child of God. And He loves you. So Lord God, as we take our offering this morning, help us to remember that you can make all things new. Help us to remember that each of the ingredients in our lives is so important, and that you are present in each of them. Because of COVID, we ask if you'd like to bring your offering to the front, please do so. If not, we'll come around with a basket. So please come forward.
In the pushing, in the pressing, you are making new wine. In the soil I now surrender, you are breaking new ground. So I hear so make me an offering, make me whatever you want me to be. I came here with nothing, but all you have given me, Jesus, bring new wine.
Genesis 12, you said to Abraham, I will bless you so that you could be a blessing. Thank you, Lord God, for the blessings that you give us each and every day, for the wherewithal to be the ingredients of love in somebody else's life, to bring light where there's darkness and love where there's hatred, to bring the spirit of Mandy alive, to make a new one. We make this prayer in Jesus' name.
On the night Jesus was betrayed,
Yesterday to start setting things up here. Things were running really good, you know what I'm saying? Everything was like, yo, the lights are working, the balloons are ready, everything's set. When I got here this morning, Danny goes, Pastor, the electricity went out. I'm like, all right, cool. Then Max went over to get the balloons, and she said, oh, they'll be ready by 10 o'clock. I'm like, okay, cool. Then we were trying to open the door to get the electricity outside so the speaker, we couldn't open the door. Then Anthony had a boss that told me I had to come to work by 10 o'clock. Yeah. You see, what happens here is this, and I want you all to hear this, especially my incredible people here at the FCC. As we do good works, the enemy is going to attack. And as we continue to shine, he's going to attack us. So we got to be strong, amen? We got to say, we got the Lord on our side. Who else can come against us? No one. If God is for us, who can be against us? We need to think of that and remember that each and every day. Next week, we're going to be celebrating our school, and we're asking our students to all come to service next week. It will be a celebration of the ministry that Miss Sandy has done in all the 21, what is it? 75? 75 years of ministry. Sometimes it seems like that, right? We welcome Ryan. Ryan, your team is doing so good, right? No? Bad? Well, yeah, you won the other day. I saw your picture. You're beautiful. I'm so proud of you. Way to go, man. It's good to see Ryan here. Matt, how you doing? Everything's good? Pastor Inez is here, and Pastor Inez will be starting the Alpha program, the Hispanic Alpha program, sometime in October. Pastor Inez is also going to be painting our lobby area over there, so we are so grateful and thankful for you. The Alpha program will also be in English, and that'll be starting sometime in October. This week is Bible study on Wednesday. We have Women's Guild on Tuesday, is that correct? Women's Guild at 6:30 on Tuesday. Where would they come in through? From here? From this side here. So if you go to the front of the church and you want to be part of the Women's Guild, they really need help, okay? So if you could be there. Dan, you can't go to that, okay, because it's called the Women's Guild, okay? So this week, like I said, Wednesday is a Bible study. And you know, we'd be remiss if we didn't thank our music ministers. You know, they work tirelessly. Nicole, we are so grateful that you are here. Nicole was the one that had, she's going to be putting together a school of music up in our area upstairs. And she's already been to the Bayshore Library. She's already pushing so that people come. See, the more people that come through the door, right, Ruben? The more people that come through the door, they feel the presence of God. And you had COVID. You didn't have COVID, but you were exposed. So, and you're all good now? All right, so we thank you. As always, Jade. Jade is an incredible violinist. She is, they call her violinist, right? Yeah, so I thought it was a, like, healing sort of. How about a nice round of applause for Jane? And then, of course, our leader, Daniel. You are so good. You just do whatever is necessary. And then we are blessed with my friend, who has given her time endlessly. She's here on Wednesday. She's here. Maureen, we are blessed by you. Thank you, Maureen. And there's so many countless numbers of other people, like Anthony and Max, and so many people that help us out throughout the week to make things happen here. With that being said, we are so grateful. We got an ice cream party. The ice cream truck should be here. Gil, would you just go check where he is? It's Mario. I don't know. Maybe it might be best if he pulled in the front of the church here. Gil, what do you think? Is that okay?
No, maybe you'll go.
In the parking lot? Well, because I want to give some. Okay, whatever. Oh, Gil, you're the boss. Make a decision.
I'll make an executive.
Make that executive call. Did you all have a good time? It wasn't too long, was it? Was it all right?
No.
I'm exhausted. I'm going to go home, make the lasagna, and then go to sleep. That's what I want to do. This is exhausting to me. But as always, I am so grateful for the two of you. And, I'm not gonna tear up, I promise. I am just so grateful for the two of you, for the resiliency and the fortitude that you two have shown me, and anything that I go through, I always put it in comparison to what you've been through, and that how you're making it through, but I know it's still a struggle each and every day. So I thank you for that from the bottom of my heart. With that being said, Father God, I ask your blessings on everybody here. We thank you for those blessings. We thank you that we are your children. We thank you that you are our God. Help us to rely on that each and every day. In Jesus' name we pray. With that being said, our final hymn is Joyful, Joyful. Please stand as we conclude our service. and as our blessing is, go and live in the faithfulness of God. Go with the love and the mercy of Jesus Christ. Go with the presence of the Holy Spirit, guiding your actions and decisions. And be sure that you understand it's in the small thing, in the quiet things, that you'll find the Lord. Just wait. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.